Hello students, welcome to this session. In this session we are going to study the set bounds method. The set bound method is used when you do not want to use any default or any other layout manager provided by Java. In this small example, what we will do is we will make use of this set bounds method, and I'll explain you how the component will be displayed on the container. Now you can see here the first import statement is import java.awt.star. Then you have got the class declaration, public class set bounds demo. Okay, then you have started the main method, right? And inside the main method we have instantiated an object of the frame class. That means you have taken the frame class, okay, you have created an object of the frame class, F1 is equal to new frame. Now when you run this program, right, what will happen is a frame will be displayed, and whatever information you have put inside the double quotations. Now here inside the double quotations I have made use of a string IAIT Latur. This will be displayed in the title bar of the frame. Now the next important one is f1.setLayoutNull. Remember students, for every container there is a default layout manager which is set by Java. Now since I am going to make use of a frame, the default layout for the frame is the border layout. But I do not want to make use of the border layout. So I first need to use this method setLayout, and for this method I need to pass the argument null, which informs Java that you already given me a default layout, but I am not interested in using that one. I am going to put the components manually. That means the component where it should be on the screen, on that container, what is the coordinate, everything I will be putting it myself, and for that one I will be making use of the method set bounds. Okay, now set bounds method has got four arguments, right? And here in these four arguments I have passed the values 100, 150, 80 and 50. Now what is this set bounds method, we will see. Now see here, now the set bounds method, this is the set bounds method. The set bounds method needs four arguments. The first two arguments are x and y coordinates of the top left corner of the component. The third argument is the width of the component, that is this one, the width of the component. And the fourth argument is the height of the component. This is what you should remember here. Okay. The set bounds method la char arguments asthan, and chari arguments set data type is integer. At the set bounds method, first one is integer x coordinate, integer y coordinate, integer width and integer height. These are the four values which you will be requiring. Okay. Now his same example, it is there here. Button b1 is equal to new button. Button's a default constructor me use kele. And when this button is displayed on the frame, the text that will be written on the button is press here. Now t1.setBounds 100, 150, 80, 50. That means buttons as a top left corner hai, manje buttons a pahila position je hai, that will be x axis madhi 100, y axis madhi 150, the width of the button is 80 and the height of the button is 50. Then I am adding this one f1.addb1. Then I am making use of f1.setSize. Now the size here refers to this frame object f1. Okay, the size of this f1 is, that is the f1 which is the object of the frame, the width is 500 and the height is 500. Now another important thing is, by default a frame when it is created it is not visible. For that you will have to make use of a method, that is setVisible, and this method takes a boolean argument. When it is true, the frame will be visible on the screen. This is the end of the main method. I'll write it here. As I've told you, it's a good practice to write the comments, end main, and then I'll end the class. Now when you run this program, here I will show it to you. I run this program. First I will compile this one, Java C set bounds demo.java. Oh, there is a spelling mistake here, sorry. Java C set bounds demo.java. The program got compiled. Now it is an application program. That means it contains the main method. So I'll have to use Java. I need not use Applet Weaver. Java set bounds demo. And when you are using this main method, it is called as an application program. And to run this program, .java is not necessary. But for compiling, set bounds demo.java. But for the execution of the program, .java you should not give. But if it is an applet program, then Applet Weaver, name of the program, .java you should specify. Now if you see here, this is the output which I am getting here. And in this output, if you look at this output here very carefully, you'll be able to see that here this is the frame output which is displayed here. Now the first arguments, if you remember, right, the x-axis means the distance from this particular point, right? Just observe where my mouse pointer is. This is from this point to this point, this distance is 100, and this distance from the top to here, this distance is 150. The width of this button is 80 and the height of this button is some 60. Okay, now this is what we have specified in the code here. What is that we have specified here? 100 comma 150 and 80 comma 50. Now I'll put this here side by side. Now again I'll show you, 100 comma 150 is this particular location, manje the top left corner of the button. The top left corner of the button is along the x-axis, it is 100, and along the y-axis it is 150. A button's width is 80 and button height is 50. Okay, and he frames a width, it is 500, and frames a height is also 500. Okay, this is a very simple method, set bounds. Okay, now you can see the same output here. Again I'll show it to you, b1 dot set bounds. So the basics you should remember, set bounds requires 4 arguments. The first 2 arguments specify the top left corner. You are able to see this arrow here. This point is 100 comma 150. That means along this axis, along this particular x axis, half point person, from this particular point to this point, the distance is 100 pixels. And from this top point to the top of the applet window, sorry, to the frame window, it is 150. So a buttons at this particular point will be 100 comma 150, and the width of the button is 80 and the height of the button is 50. Now he frame, when you are creating the frame, you have given one argument, f1 dot set size 500 comma 500. That is the width of this frame here. If you can see, this width of the frame here is 500 and the height of this frame is 500. Okay, this is the use of the set bounds method. I hope you have understood this one. Thank you. We'll meet in the next session.